be involved in. So stay tuned. We'll be right with you live, guys. Live.
I never even loaded to your channel. I get the link. So.
Pond 5.
Get them right away.
I know you're sitting there like, where are these guys? Why aren't they live yet? We'll be right there in a few minutes, guys. Hang in there. Stay tuned in. Keep the broadcast going. Stay tuned. We'll be live at you in a few minutes. This is Daily Hip Hop News Live with Jordan Tower and MREC, bringing you the latest hip hop news and discussion that you can be involved in. So stay tuned. We'll be right with you live, guys. Live.
Usually when on your page, usually I can see that'll be the first video. Let me go to home.
Pond 5.
I know you're sitting there like, where are these guys? Why aren't they live yet? We'll be right there in a few minutes, guys. Hang in there. Stay tuned in. Keep the broadcast going.
What's that? That's you.
Stay tuned. We'll be live at you in a few minutes. This is Daily Hip Hop News Live with Jordan Tower and MREC, bringing you the latest hip hop news and discussion that you can be involved in. So stay tuned. We'll be right with you live, guys. Live. These guys, why aren't they live yet? We'll be right there in a few minutes, guys. Hang in there. Stay tuned in. Keep the broadcast going. Stay tuned. We'll be live at you in a few minutes. This is Daily Hip Hop News Live with Jordan Tower and MREC, bringing you the latest hip hop news and discussion that you can be involved. So stay tuned. We'll be right with you live, guys. Live.
All right, let's go. Yo, what's good, everybody? Welcome to, what is it, Thursday now, Rec? It's already Thursday?
Yes, sir.
Damn.
Thursday.
Thursday already, man.
Woo! Almost the end of the week.
Beanie Siegel dropped that fire diss track. I mean, I listened to that, 10, 20 times today? What about you, Rec?
I was getting my two-step onto that, man. It had a nice little groove to it, too. And he was going in with the bars, the flows, and all that. That's the Siegel I know. That's Beanie Siegel with the new voice.
Hell yeah.
That's the old Beanie Siegel with the new voice.
Yeah, yeah. He got that new little voice going on. What are you guys thinking about the new Beanie Siegel voice? Is it good? You like it? I don't know. I mean, I kind of like the more aggressive Beanie Siegel, but the bars are there.
Bars is superb.
Luke Keys in the room as always. Designers are Russ, a deadly wishable dog man. So we're kind of figuring out the whole thing with the going live and having the interviews, right, Rec? We're figuring that out. So I figure we'll do two interviews in the beginning of the week, right? And then we'll go live like this the rest of the week. So, you know, we'll fix it up.
Yes, sir.
We'll fix it up, guys. We're just figuring all this live stuff out. You know, we've only been going live for about, 2 weeks now, Rec? 2 weeks.
About 2 weeks, 2.5 the most, you know?
Yeah, man. And we're loving it, man. And we love all the support. I'm getting, all kinds of support from you guys. You know, emails. You know, shout out to the brands that are hauling at us to do, brand deals on here. They haven't completely followed through yet, but it's happening. Okay, we're trying to get brand deals. Shout out to all the Patreon guys. We're going to shout you out in the middle of the broadcast so everyone can recognize that you donated to the podcast or videocast, we'd have to call this, right, Rec?
Videocast, live stream, podcast, whatever you feel comfortable with.
So, Rec, how was your day today? Tell them.
My day started off good when I got that beans disc, you know what I'm saying, early in the morning and start the day off right, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's my day start off fiery, just like them bars was, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know. Rec put me onto that beans disc early. I had to go to the dry cleaner, get my polo out the dry cleaner. I had to bring it back to the polo for today.
You brought the polo back.
I had to bring the polo back for you guys. Now, Beanie Siegel. Damn, Beanie Siegel was going in today, Rec, wasn't he?
Man,
what
did he say?
What did he say about the private jet? He went to go to Teterboro to get the private jet. But no jets leaving. You're leaving in a cab. What'd he say? I gotta bring that bars up.
The only thing is the pardon is death. Something like that. Woo!
That shit was hard. Beanie Siegel.
Like, Meek Mill woke up a sleeping giant. Beans does
yeah,
this.
You messed like, up. I like that part where he's like, right when I thought I was out, they pulled me back in. The Godfather, that famous Godfather line.
Yo, I'm gonna be honest with you. A lot of people thinking that, oh, the beans this was like, listen to it again. Clean out your ears.
Guys,
those are some of the best bars I heard. Besides Game Pest Control and Game 92 bars, Bean shit is up there.
Wreck, I think we're going to have to break down these lyrics to these guys. That's what I think. I think we're going to have to go into the lyrics, okay? I just pulled up the lyrics over here, okay? Let me get the window right. Okay. Here's the I'm Coming lyrics. I don't even know where to put them on the window. Okay, well, I'll put them in between us. All right. So the ones I thought the end was the strongest part. What do you think?
Yeah, what, the third verse, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, mean.
He said, stop this bigger than Amika. I wanted you and ITY Latifah. What does the ITY mean? Itty Latifah?
You and the ITY. That's Queen Latifah.
Ah, yeah.
Killed it. That's what I said. Listen to the bars. Anybody in here saying Beans bars was light or it was a warm-up or it was cool, you're not listening. Do your homework. You know what I mean? We talking about metaphors, similes, double entendres, bean flows, wordplay. Y'all got to get on your shit. This is hip-hop shit we talking tonight. We ain't talking this sing-along bullshit y'all used to. We talking bars, hip-hop shit.
Now, okay, so we got now laying between. Okay, he said, you drew the line, so I'm going to cross it. Now laying between them lines, then they chalk. When they chalk it, I'm going to kill you. Ain't no jets to pardon, only death to pardon.
Woo. Yes, sir.
Teterboro with the barrel, exercise the plan. Understand you ain't never too fly to land.
Damn.
Bars.
Damn. See, y'all got to listen again. Do your homework.
Wait, let me go back into the thing.
We're doing y'all a favor.
Yeah.
Hell because yeah. A lot of y'all sleeping. Y'all don't get it.
Ah, shit's crazy, bro. So, yeah, let's go to the live chat and see what people are talking about. We got 54 people going to say,
yeah, we got
name five suckers in rap. Okay, we got sing along.
There's some people in here from Michigan that were shouting me out. Let me get to them. State your name right now so I can see y'all because I can't go all the way back. Yeah. I'm not doing that right now. I'm on that drink right now. I'm drinking that Henny and that cranberry.
Damn. Okay, let's read some people's thing. What do you guys think about the diss? Did anybody listen to the diss? Beans is more believable and sounded great for Halloween. The chalk line was tough. These youngins don't care about hip-hop. Shit is new era. I'm from era and I still think it's weak. Gee, he mad at the wrong guy. Meek didn't punch him. Let's see. MREC, shout out to Looking for the True. Should be the one who's reading the lyrics, bro, not Jordan. Why?
Yo, shots to Looking for the Truth. Nah, let Jordan read them lyrics out, man. You know,
yo, Rec guy, doesn't want to bring the lyrics up. He's too lazy today.
blame it on me being lazy.
Blame it on the alcohol.
Yeah, blame it on the alcohol. I definitely got that Henny and that cranberry, huh?
The voice low, though, I hate it. Yeah, they don't like the Beanie low voice. MREC, what up? Where is Meek's block? Yeah, where are they? Did he mention dude that punched him? Yes, he did. We're going to get into that right now.
Oh,
Prince O'Mill from Zamunda. I like the name, JT Peace.
See, when they say that, I know y'all ain't listened to that diss.
Yeah, you ain't listened to it because let's go back to the diss lyrics, guys. Okay, I'm going to show you right where he said.
We're taking y'all to school right now. We going to school them.
What do you say?
Where boom, my hitters at in this room? I don't see my normal hitters. I see looking for the truth.
You just a tweeter. I'm the knocking the devil speaker.
Woo! Stop playing, Jordan. Keep going.
Okay, here's the one that goes towards Teefy. Gee, what dudes do for money? My brother's keeper. A sucker way out is to steal. Him. Face said, look into the eyes before you kill him. You weak for real. You did that for Meek. You should have did it for Mills. Like, you should have did it for money. Then what do you say?
What y'all gotta understand?
You should have did it for real. You should have shot me.
What y'all gotta understand about Bean's voice? You gotta understand. Leave the old voice in the past. This the new Beans. So just focus on the bars, and you got a new voice. That's it. We can't keep focusing on his new voice. Y'all got to get used to it. Pay attention to the bars. You know what I'm saying? It's a new day.
Word up.
You know what I'm saying? Salute. Big C Music, salute.
Damn, this thing's tripping. Hold on.
ZS Freestyle, salute. Jer Green, salute. Kumami?
Green, Kinblood, Kuani Levy, Word to Come, and Designers R Us, The One Lung Voice, Whisper Rap, Freestyles, Street Life Records, Life Music, Firebug Sar. What's up, guys?
Sign
What's
up? Us.
Share the stream. Ghost Share the stream. Storm. Share the stream, guys. Share it.
Share the stream. Like it. Share.
Said that voice was spooky.
That's what we want. We want that spooky voice.
What else we got? A Deadly Wishable.
Bill Barker, salute. Higher Wisdom, salute.
That Boy Andrew Young, Arthur, what's up? Salute. AZ Freestyles, wisdom, Jordan Towers, salute. A rapper. I used to be a rapper a long time ago.
Troy Jenkins, salute.
MREC filmed my first video.
Word. That's a fact.
Billy Parker, JT. Yo, hit that Patreon.
Patreon.
Salute to everybody that hit that Patreon before. That shit was live. You guys got it up to $200 right now.
Yo, and let's do this. Julio Rivera, what up? Julio, what up? The beat was hot, too. I can't front. Beat was hot, and he was gliding on that shit.
Shout out to Jersey. Flowing.
Beans was gliding on the beat. Y'all can't deny that. Like,
nah, it was hard.
That was a record, and I was doing my two-step to it, too. See, you got to listen to it. When you can listen to a diss record and dance to it, you know he on his A-game.
That was like, yo, I liked the vibe of the song. It was some old-school classic shit, right?
Yes, sir.
Nah, I was feeling it. You gotta hear that track loud. Yo, you guys gotta put your headphones on and play that Beans track. We're gonna get back to the diss track, but let's really get into the French Montana right now.
I'm hearing Scrapped Album. I'm hearing Scrapped
Album. I told you guys French Montana wasn't hot. I told you he wasn't hot right now. He just doesn't have the buzz. Do Rec and I respect the hustle? Of course.
Look, I respect the hustle. I grustle. Grind plus hustle, grustle.
Shout out to French Montana's hustle. But the buzz ain't there right now, and he's got to find it. He's got to find the buzz right now. Max B, he needs Max P home now. He needs him home.
So let's put him on to what's going on.
Okay.
In current news, French Montana, Scrap, Mac and Cheese, Part 4, which was his debut album. Well, not debut.
No.
Which was
sophomore.
His album.
That sophomore was album. Sophomore.
Yeah, sophomore album. Yeah. That was coming out. Well, it was supposed to came out August. But then again, he changed the date to October.
Let's be honest, Rec. It's basically a DJ Khaled album. A lot of features. Woo! A lot of features.
But that's what French is known for.
It's true. He's a feature king. You know, Pop That was mostly features. That's how we got his start, Rec. Pop That was all features. You heard French Montana for 4 bars. Okay? 4 bars. He needs Max home because Max B really got French a start. Like, We knew French from Cocaine City. Emrek and I know him personally. Okay? He was killing it with the Cocaine City. Ingenious idea to get your brand popping. Okay? Get some hot people, mix in your videos, get features with popping rappers. Genius. Okay? Then Max B, he was able to embrace Max B, and Max B had a buzz that went off like no other, going at Jim Jones, going at Chrissy. He embraced that, went on for the ride. Max B helped him learn how to like record differently and do different types of hooks and everything. And then Max B got locked up, so he ran with the wave. That was going to be Max B's wave, but he had to run with it.
I give him his credit because you have dudes who rock with rappers that's hot, and the rapper get locked up. And then the whole dynasty falls apart.
Oh, yeah. We're not totally bashing French Montana. Yeah. We got to give him his props.
Shout to French because he held it down.
He held it down for Max B.
And he got that Coke Boys brand popping. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And he didn't do it lyrically. He did it by having good business and and networking. Mm-hmm. He had a good networking system that worked for him. He was able to get up on Drake, Rick Ross, and Waka Flocka.
Guys, this is how the French Montana thing went. He did the Cocaine City, okay? Then he got he attached himself to Akon, okay? That didn't quite work out. Attached himself to Deborah, Waka, Gucci. Then attached himself to Rick Ross, which in turn got attached himself to Diddy, and here he is. That's how it went. Now, the beginning with the Cocaine City, he attached himself to the Wave God, Max B.
I mean, you broke it down.
Okay. Now, Chinks was there to help him throughout the Rick Ross and Diddy deals. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Chinks passed away. God bless the dead.
R.I.P. Chinks. R.I.P.
Chinks. R.I.P. Shorty Low always.
Okay? R.I.P. Shorty Low. G.
Now, with Chinks is gone, who he had Manolo Rose around, right? What happened?
Manolo Rose was looking like he was Coke about Boys. To be a Coke Boy. And then all of a sudden, he made a U-turn. And now he's signed a Memphis Bleak label. Rock Nation.
I saw that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Damn. So, okay. So.
It's spooky out here.
He lost his affiliations with French. French should have held on because Manolo Rose seems like a good writer, right?
He do his thing. Salute.
So basically, what's going on here, guys? So now it seems like French Montana is waiting for Max B to come home to start a label. That's smart. Okay? He needs Max B around to stay hot. He needs some of that energy.
Blood, salute. He said the bad boy curse. Wow. Wow.
That's true. That's a real thing. That's a bad bad. That boy. Look, name one person that went beyond Puff, right? Besides, the Locks got out of that bad boy. They beat it. They got out early, right?
Mm-hmm.
They saw it coming. They got out early.
There was some turmoil before they got out early too.
Oh yeah. Refrigerators and all that.
Jada Kiss say yeah. Feel like dropping a refrigerator on somebody. And then Puff called up like,
word.
Look, Puff said, Jadakiss, you and I know you ain't throwing no refrigerator on nobody. Cut it out.
Yo, I'm going to be honest. If I was French Montana, I would start embracing Lil Durk a little more, right? Lil Durk's kind of hot out there in Chicago, right?
I mean, you got to understand, one thing about French, he's not leaving that spotlight for somebody else to get it. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, now, the Chink situation was different. And I really don't want to elaborate, but for those who know what I'm saying.
Right. Yeah. Right.
You get what I'm saying?
No, who am I? Who am I? Right.
Now, Diddy was going crazy on the Locks on the radio, like, and you see, you know, Jada, my guy, Styles P, Sheik, those the homies, but Diddy called up, it got different.
Yeah.
It got different. It got dark in the room. It got dark at the radio station. He said, cut it out.
Who said cut it out?
Diddy. Oh. He said, y'all ain't throwing no refrigerator on nobody. That's the nobody.
Yo, he don't want that beef. Diddy don't want that beef.
You know? Yo. And not that, I'm not discrediting nobody gangster, but I'm just calling what it is. It's on MREC TV.
Yo, Rec, let's be honest here, okay? Let's be honest. What's going on here? I mean, anybody that aligns themselves with Drake, right? Okay. Is out of here. I mean, that no shopping was dope, right? Am I wrong?
Yeah, but you gotta understand.
What's up?
French already had his loop with Drake.
So you can only milk the cow so much.
There you go.
Yo, I think that's the same case with 2 Chainz. 2 Chainz, if you don't know, has a single out with Drake right now that's moving like at a snail's pace.
2 Chainz had his, he had his loop with Drake too.
He had his Drake run.
So pay attention. People got to understand. Pay attention to history.
Yo, is Iggy Azalea, is she sabotaging French Montana right now? Well, is that ass blinding them?
Check it. See, now French, he's smart. He became bigger than a rapper. He became a socialite. Okay. So now these chicks, these movie chicks like, what's that, Sanaa Lathan.
Yeah.
And you got the pop chick, what's her name? Iggy Azalea, right?
Yes, sir.
He's able to, I guess, sweet talk these chicks, beat they box up, and use them for press. It's smart. It's bigger than rap. Yeah. You understand what I'm saying?
Nah,
and somebody just said it. Firebug saw French suck souls. He said it, not me. You feel me?
Yeah.
And that, French is a smart dude. You dig?
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm not here to bash nobody. That's not what I do. You feel me? I just call it for what it is. I leave it up to y'all to do
that. Oh, my gosh. We got Samaya Kane in the room.
Samaya Kane. What's happening?
A veteran.
Huh?
Who else? We got Les Villegas, Jared Green, Tim Dillon, Samaya Kane, Tim Dillon again with he's coming in with these fucking, yes, lots of chats.
Kardashian chick, yeah. French was knocking down Chloe. Let's not for
French
let's
Neat
not
Max.
Forget.
That's true. Mystery Montana. I like that. Mystery Montana. Yo, salute everybody. Salute. We got Matic World.
Hold on.
I bet French fuck Diddy girl.
They got a CD pulled off the shelf. Damn. Hold on. Salute, Lou Keys. I mean, you know, I had to pull it out. I had it in the stash, so I had to pull it out. I had the purple grind plus hustle grind shirt.
Yo, you know what Rec told me this morning? He said, yo, today I'm getting fresh on this cast.
Nah, I ain't even say that.
He said, yo, I'm going out to get an outfit.
I'm so regular right now. Nah, this ain't even an outfit, man. I took this out the dryer. I took this hat from the hat rack. It had a lot of dust on it. I'm regular, man.
Oh,
I just like the coordinate.
Someone just brought up True Life being quiet since you came home. I agree with you. Where is True Life? Yo.
Now, you got to understand.
What's up?
True Life, ever since that prison bid.
He's different?
It changed him. He's not the same True Life.
Okay.
Something might have happened in prison. Because I seen that happen to dudes who was talking crazy or always on that rah-rah. They go to prison, come home, be humble. So something might have happened in prison. Not to say he wasn't holding it down, but I seen that happen numerous times. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, let's take a timeout. Let's take a timeout. We got to take a timeout. We got to let these people know. If you're in here and you got a product, you email me, JordanTowerFilms@gmail.com. We're going to broker. We're going to do an advertisement for your product and put it in here. We'll work out the pricing. I just had to give a plug real quick. Let's get right back into it. French Montana, MC4. You know what really happened? L.A. Reid said, yo, French, you ain't hot. You ain't hot, bro. We cancel on the album. We're going to push it to 2017. We're going to call it something else. This mac and cheese thing just ain't working. It ain't working.
So basically, L.A. Reid made the call.
Come on, L.A. Reid was covering for him last time. French Montana said there was sample clearances. L.A. Reid said, hey, I got to clear this up because we ain't having no sample clearances over here at Epic. He said, yo, basically this is what happened, all right? He needs to put a little more work in. Well, he put a little more work in, and guess what? It wasn't enough work, guys, okay? Share the stream, guys. Get people in here. Okay, Max B, right? Max B needs to come home and help French write. I mean, I wish Max B could get some tracks in jail through JPay or something and help help this guy, French Montana, come back. Because we all want to see the Wave God on top when he comes home. Right, right?
Facts. Listen. I just want to see Max shine. Like, I mean, French, you shined already. Let the homie come home and let him get a good 2-year run. You know what I mean? Just put them calls in. Let Max get them booked up shows for 20, 30 grand. I want French Montana to act as Max B manager. Let Max get his wave on. You know what I'm saying?
I think that's a great loop, Breck. I think that's what they need to do. Max B comes home. French Montana pushes Max B to the front. Gets the Drake verses. Gets all that. Gets the 2 Chainz, everybody on the album. And then this thing will really start smoking. Okay? Because we all know Max B was set to be a star. I didn't believe in Max when he first got with Jim Jones with the pin the tail on the donkey. But he won me over after that Million Dollar Baby mixtape. I'm going to keep it honest.
Yeah.
That shit was hard.
Shout out to Lazy K, too. DJ Lazy K.
Yeah, that shit was hard, Wreck. And then, you know.
And shouts to Murder, too.
Yo, talking about bars, right? Beanie Siegel, man. We got to get back to that. Beanie Siegel destroyed Meek Mill today. He destroyed him. I mean, how are you going to come back from this, Wreck?
Yo, hold on. Teefy Bay reached out to his cousin. Yeah. He's supposed to call me. I don't know if he's going to call me during the show.
I hope he does.
They reached out last night, and they reached out a few minutes ago. So
okay. We want the answers. Yeah. We want the answers. I hope Meek Mill, right? I mean, where is this DC4? Got pushed back again, man. I mean, I'm doing my best to support this guy, but he's making it hard, right, Rack? He's making it hard.
He making it hard, man. And then Siegel and Game coming with that shit. So hopefully this is inspiration and motivation for him to go back into DC4 and cook up some more shit. You know what I'm saying?
I hope he doesn't take the route like this. Like, oh, I ain't going to respond because it ain't worth it. Nah, you got to show and prove right now, bro. You got to show and prove right now.
Nah, definitely. But this is where you separate the boys from the men. We going to see.
Yo, you know what? When we get Teefy on the phone, because we're going to get Teefy on the phone somehow.
Yeah, Skype, he reached out.
Okay? And we're going to get him on here. And basically, Teefy Bay is going to break it down. Like, I want the answers. Why? Why?
And for those that don't know who Teefy Bay is.
He's the one who punched me.
The dude that knocked out Beanie Siegel. Okay?
Yeah.
He reached out last night to me through his cousin. And, his cousin hit me again, like, maybe an hour ago, say he's going to call me. So he might call during the show, and I might just have him live over the phone for y'all. Me and Jordan have him live on the phone for y'all.
I have a question with you guys. What about Michael Watts? Should we get Michael Watts up here on the show? Do you even know who Michael Watts is from Texas? Should we get him on here? Do you guys want to even hear from him? What's the word?
Word, what's the word out there?
Do you want to hear from Michael Watts?
Yeah. Shouts to Julio. He said it was a sucker punch. You're right. Yeah, TP
okay,
Bay.
Nobody wants
punch,
Michael dude. Watts. So D Candy said yeah, but Julio Rivera said nah.
Damn.
Okay.
DC4 gonna be trash.
Who is Watts?
Dead.
Michael Watts. See?
Damn.
JT right left.
We reading the chats too. We gotta let it
Michael
be known.
Michael Watts 5,000.
When it rebroadcasts, I don't want dudes thinking we hating. So
I got the chat up so they can see it.
No, I'm talking about on the rebroadcast. They're not able to see it.
Oh no, they can see it. I have it up.
Okay.
I have the chat running on the side.
Oh, okay. Dope.
Guys, shout yourselves out. If you want to be shouted out, just plug your shit right there. I got you guys right up in the corner. You see yourself.
Get AR app, yeah. You know what? I'm gonna get AR app and Dark Glow. We're gonna get it. We're gonna make it happen. Okay. Shouts to Julio, man. Always locked in and all that.
Word up, word up. Okay, Jared Green, what's up? Get Jazz Prince. We're working on that. I'll work on that. That's the guy Paul Wald shouts out, right, bro? Yeah, 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 that's him. Rick Ross going to sacrifice Meek so he can be rich forever. Get 50 Cousin Continental. Oh, nah. We ain't getting him on here. It's over for him. I'm sorry.
Yeah. He said it.
We tried to make it work a long time ago.
Me and Jordan tried.
We shot videos with him and everything. It just didn't catch, bro. Sometimes it's not like you can't make people like your art, right?
Nah, I mean, I did get him a crazy buzz. I ain't going to go into that deals and all that, but
Yeah.
I'm going to leave it alone. Some people are just ungrateful, and we're going to leave it as that.
But I ain't going to lie to you guys. You know what I mean? I'm not taking shots, Julio Rivera. I'm just keeping it real, okay? Like, if Meek called me on the phone right now and said, yo, am I losing the battle? I'd have to say, yo, you are, bro. Get in the studio, bro. Come on, we want to hear them bars.
JT going to tell Meek, yo, gang smoking your boots out there.
I'm going to be like, yo, bro, we need to hear some more bars. I need to hear Meek. I need to hear Hungry Meek from a few years ago. I think that sometimes, Rec, I mean, I'll be honest with you. We both had
Trill
girls.
For life. Salute.
Let's be honest, Rec. Okay, we both had girls, and sometimes your girl can get you off your game.
I would love Brian Pumper for an interview, though. That dude is funny as shit. Like,
yo, what do you guys think about 50 Tyson for an interview? 50 Tyson. What did I have to go? 50 Tyson? What do you guys think about 50 Tyson for an interview? Remember 50 Tyson? Interview Yo Gotti. I'm working on that. How long before Nicki leave Meek? Right after Christmas.
Oh, you wild.
Who?
Let's see. Put that in the universe. Now, if that shit happened, that shit crazy.
I've been saying that's going to happen, man. I hope it doesn't for him, but I think Meek just needs to get better.
Rider right now? Crazy. No 50 Tyson. Amir G, what's happening?
50 Tyson. Does anybody want 50 Tyson on here?
Yeah.
We won't do the whole interview with 50. We'll do it live with 50 Tyson, like real live, so he could read the chat with us. They're complaining because our stream just caught up, guys. It was delayed for a second. I saw it being delayed. Yeah, I couldn't fix it, though, because I would have to kill the stream and bring it back. But it just caught up, guys. I'm sorry about that.
Is that going to fix it on YouTube on a rebroadcast?
No, because it was the OBS lagging, but it's back up.
Damn, that OBS.
Hey, OBS be tripping. OBS be tripping. Okay, Les Verlis, what's up? Looking for the truth. You guys got to share the stream. I want to see that number over 100 at all times. We're at 87. If you guys aren't sharing the stream, we're going to end the stream early. I need that number at 100 or better.
Fuck out here if y'all don't share that stream.
We're working hard in here. Yo, and you know what? You know, I appreciate everybody that already donated.
Now, I appreciate y'all. Share that stream. Stop playing.
But we need more Patreons. We need more Patreons.
Send them Patreons. Stop playing. I got to get on my shit with y'all. I be too cool with y'all.
Word.
Send them Patreons in, man. Stop fucking playing. Nah. I'm going to start going.
Yo, Rex getting gangster.
Upside your fucking head right now. All y'all in the chat room, man.
Rex,
send them Patreons.
Gangster.
Stop playing, man.
Yo, Raw Uncut Films, what up? Ghosts with the Wind. Raw Uncut Films, who inspired you to start shooting
Mac,
videos?
Man. Get more followers. Let's do it, man. Stop playing. Let's get it.
Yo, let's get more people in here. Follow.
Let's get it.
Make sure you hit that subscribe button. And today, guys, I just want to announce, you know, we had Wendy Day on the cast a few days ago. Well, I just set up her YouTube channel today. It took me about 5 hours. I got her all set up. She's ready to go. She's going to be going live on Wednesdays answering your questions. And she's going to be on here on our channel once a week, giving you insight on how to get into the music game, okay? Giving you all the questions you want. And
yo,
she's
Joe Biden about to get blocked.
I got Wendy Day dropping Monday,
about to
Wednesday,
get
Friday.
Yo,
check
get
out
that
Lenny
Joe
Blanco,
Biden.
Man. What,
see his
what,
ass
what
up in the
y'all?
Chat room, y'all. He talking shit.
Trillville, MREC, Jordan Taylor, I told y'all next week I'm when I get paid. Trill Life, thank you for that. Freestyles, do you guys fuck with DJ Vlad? He's cool.
Tear their asses up. Like, we not having it no more. It's war. You talk shit in the chat room? Yeah, I ain't snitching. Look, dude, how I'm snitching? We on a live broadcast. Everybody see your bullshit you doing. I'm snitching. Everybody see what you typing.
Tim Dillon.
See, that's why the game fucked up, because when you a street dude, you know how to analyze what snitching is. When you not, you just say everything's snitching. You typing for the world, you say I'm snitching.
All right.
Next.
Damn, bro.
It's a new date.
I'm going to tell you one thing, guys. Rex over there drinking, so this is a different Rex.
Yeah. Fuck with me if you want.
Yeah. Anyways.
Night.
Rex acting like kind of spooky right now.
Spooky.
Yo, you're kind of spooky right now over there, Rex.
Fuck it. They got to send them Patreons in. They got to start sharing this motherfucking live broadcast.
Is Avery in here? Where's Avery at? I don't see Avery. Where's Avery at?
motherfucking ceiling fan on. Hold on, y'all.
Where's Avery at? Where's Avery at? Spooky! Yo, guys, make sure you hit that Patreon, okay?
Man, I be too cool, man.
No, be nice to them, bro.
You know, salute to y'all, man, but I be too cool, man.
Yeah, salute to everybody up in here. Yo, so, Rec, what did you feel when you first heard that Beanie disc, the first reaction? What was it? What were you talking? What were you thinking?
Hold on, let me address this person real quick.
Why?
The Diddy Bodyguard
oh.
thing is coming out November live stream.
Okay.
The last uploads, go to my MREC TV, Diddy former bodyguard. Look under the link, and you're going to see the GoFundMe, and y'all find out when it's coming out. All right, I'm sorry, Jordan. Ask me that question again.
Yo, what was your first reaction off the Beanie Siegel diss?
I said, Beans is back. I said, oh, shit. Whoa! That's my first reaction. I said, because while I was listening to it, I hit you. I said, oh, shit, yo, Jordan, I got to call you back. Siegel shit dropped.
Yeah.
Right or wrong?
True.
And I sent it to you. I said, oh, shit. Fire.
True. It was true. Like, yeah, you told me.
It was refreshing. Because I want to hear bars, you know, because that's what I'm about. I give dudes them bars. Similes. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Metaphors. Double entendres. That's what we do.
Give me your favorite bars, Rick. Give me your favorite bars.
See, I got to look at the paper. I don't remember his lyrics. I only heard it like 3-4 times, but I got to look at, you know, his lyrics on the paper.
So basically what you're telling me is you a fake fan.
Nah, I'm not a fake fan. I'm just not a dick rider. I like what I hear, but I'm not, you know, I can't fucking.
What was your favorite verse, though? Do you remember a verse?
Third verse was the favorite.
Ghost with the Wind. Song, Ghost with the Wind. This is my third coffee, venti. I'm on that coffee right now, and Rex on that liquor. So
yeah,
I'm on a high right now. He's on the low, but a crazy low. You see how he's acting erratic right now? Rex in a different zone right now. This is a different kind of Rex. This is Rec on the Henny. See, woo! When you're drinking the brown liquor, that makes you a little crazy, right, Rec? But the white liquor keeps you kind of calm and mellow. So Rex on the crazy liquor right now. Look at him. Look at him. He's got a Henny face right now. Look at him. It's like a happy, angry face. That's worse than just angry, Rec.
Listen, man, send them Patreons in. Send them likes and them shares to your social networks. Let's get this room popping.
We haven't got one Patreon during this whole broadcast, guys.
Yo, Joe Biden, you going to get blocked.
Why?
And our followers going to spank you. They're going to spank you. They're going to go beat stew on you.
Yo, MREC's going crazy right now.
Right? Why not? We got the room lit. Fuck it. I'm going to give y'all some entertainment, a show.
That's the first time I heard you say lit.
That's my guy.
That's the first time I heard you say lit. Oh, yo, shout out to Avery. $15. Avery Walton. You just set us over the $200 mark, Avery. I'm trying to get you up.
Avery Walton. My guy. Salute.
You see
that's
it?
What I'm talking about. See?
Ooh, Avery. My guy right there. He told me he was going to donate today, and he did it. Avery Walton, what's good, bro?
Huh? What's good, Avery Walton? You feeling my energy right now?
Avery, he's on the liquor right now. He's on the Hennessy. He's crazy today. He's going in on Meek Mill.
Look, I told you, Joe Biden. Look at Jared Green. Joe Biden eat a dick.
Yo, calm down, bro.
Nah, fuck that. We lie tonight.
Yo, you tripping tonight.
Fuck
it. You're making people, you're scaring people out of the room at an alarming pace.
Coming back. Look, they're going up, baby.
Tita Burrow with the barrel exercise. The plan understood. You ain't never too fly to land. That was a hard ass line.
Nah, Joe, you good, man. I'm chilling right now. I'm just feeling good. I'm on that liquor, but I know what I'm doing. I ain't slurring my words. I'm in control. You dig what I'm saying? But I told you, chill out. You see now, look, the chat room about to get at you. You got to chill because they going to get at you for me. You see? Shouts to Michael Sherwin. You know what I mean? Like, my peoples get at you. B-Mac know what it is. Salute.
So basically, what's his son's name from Philly that said somebody got to die?
Pipeline TV.
Yo, who said that?
Oh, you talking about TP Babe when he said somebody gotta die?
No, I'm talking about the other guy. What's his name? Come on.
You talking about this record?
Nah. In the Instagram video.
Uh-huh.
He said somebody gotta die.
You talking about Beanie Siegel?
No, I'm talking about the beef, bro. Remember when someone was commenting on the beef?
Who was commenting?
Gilly the Kid.
Oh!
So I didn't hear Beanie Siegel used that in the verse. He said, somebody gotta die, either this guy or this guy. Either way, somebody mama throwing a fish fry.
Fish fry.
Bigger the beef, bigger the clip size.
Y'all gonna say Beanie ain't go in? That shit is crazy alone.
Home Depot trips, duct tapes, and zip ties? Come on. Hey, you don't even get it.
Rewind.
He's painting a picture for you guys. Was gonna leave it dead, let the shit slide, but dude's pushing my fuck it button. I got fuck up something. I'm thinking churches and hearses, ER trips, IV drips, and nurses.
Damn. That's the old Siegel with the new voice. Y'all fucking bugging.
Damn. Then he said, "That what did he say? Homicides for Which purchase, but I think I might work this. Cash that check myself, though. Vest with the Velcro. Clip from the wrist to the elbow. Oh, my God. Draco's small, but the drum can't fit in the belt, though. Trench coat still can't tell, though.
They throw fish fries at funerals. Y'all don't get it in Philly. Oh. Y'all don't get it. Y'all don't fucking get it.
Yo, Beans, this is like, see, this is just as good as the game disc, but almost better because it's a different vibe. It's just different. Right?
Yo, the Bean shit is probably the most talked about shit for today.
Yeah.
Stop playing.
And then
Gilly definitely put something in the air, getting back to what you said about somebody gotta die, and Beans was addressing that.
Yeah.
Let's go back to that line.
Okay. He said, somebody gotta die, either this guy or this guy. Talking about Teefy Bay or Meek Mill.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Either way, somebody mama throwing a fish fry. So somebody's throwing a funeral. Woo! And that wake's going down.
See, y'all don't get it. Y'all gotta clean out your ears from that bullshit. Like, them opening bars alone set the tone.
Beanie Siegel does not play when it comes to the beef, guys.
Come on.
He doesn't play. He goes in and you took him there. You know what's crazy? Who would have known? Who would have known when Meek Mill and Beanie Siegel were in studio just, 2 weeks ago, right? 2-3 weeks ago?
Yeah, they was in the studio together.
When he said, you're going to bring me out of retirement, who thought that it was going to be Meek Mill that really brought him out of retirement? The guy he was standing next to in the studio.
It's spooky like that.
I mean, that's a loop for you. That's life.
That's why you got to be careful who you're around. Or who's around you? Watch your circle. He said it. Beanie Siegel said it. What's his classic?
What?
Fill in the air, Mac. Watch your circle. He said it to his own self.
Yo, man. So let's go to the chat room. Higher Wisdom, Slick Buffins, Disc Record, getting it. Okay, let's get into the third verse, guys, because this shit, let's break it down. Back on course with no remorse, like the fat guy from Bed-Stuy kicking doors. Break that one down, Rack.
Hold on 1 second. Let me address Joe Biden, because he said he's going to donate, and he apologized. Salute. It's all good.
Okay, let's see that Patreon. Joe Biden, let's see that. Let's see that Patreon.
That Patreon right now. It's all good.
Yo, you in the chat, Rack?
I'm in the chat. What's up?
Throw that Patreon on there for Joe Biden to go through. I'm going to do that right there. I'm going to get back into these lyrics, okay? Back on course with no remorse like the fat guy from Bed-Stuy kicking doors. We're talking about Biggie, right?
Biggie.
Okay? Everybody get on the floor. Everybody in this bitch. Get it, but the whore. Talking about Nikki, right?
Nikki.
Okay. Bitch, where the bag?
Firebug, I know you ain't leaving, homie. Stop playing. Stay up in here.
Bitch, where the bag at? Yeah, yeah, I love them too. I love them too. Is she talking to? Is he talking about he had love for Meek Mill right there? Bitch, where the bag at? Yeah, yeah, I love them too. But where the tab at? Where that tab at? Somebody cashing out or I'm blasting out. Talking about what? Ain't shit to ration out.
Dang.
You drew that line, I'm across. Okay, so let's address that, Rick. How do you feel about that? He said, yeah, yeah, I love them too, but where that tab at? Somebody cashing out or I'm blasting out. Talk about what? Ain't shit to ration out. You drew that line, so I'm across it. Okay, but before that little bar is right there. Yeah, yeah, I love him too. Is he talking about he had love for Meek Mill right there?
Yeah. Yeah, I love him too. He from the town, young boy coming up, okay. But he disrespected.
So he's talking about I love the Dream Chasers too, but they disrespected. Mm-hmm. Then he gets into that. He said, you drew that line, so I'm going to cross it. Now lay in between them lines when they chalk it. Like, this is beyond bars.
He overstepped his bounds, and now anything goes. That's basically
so
what he's
saying. Basically, when he's talking about killing Meek Mill, he's talking about his career, okay? He's saying, yo, you're going to come back down.
No, but it's bigger than that because they disrespected Seagull on man time.
Yeah, you guys.
Seagull got hands put on him.
You guys messed up. You messed up when you got Chris Seagull. Because, like, I don't get that. What I feel bad about is Meek Mill is kind of like sabotaging himself because, like, he got Drake coming for him, Game, and Beanie Siegel. Like, you don't want this much beef at one time, guys. This ain't Fogo de Chow's. This ain't Chamagucha, man. We don't want as much meat as you can eat. This ain't Arby's.
Yo, you look pissed off right there. I like that. You was pissed
off.
I'm
just
right
mad
there.
That Meek, like, why would you do this to your career? The guy was dope. He still is. But it's just looking weak out. It's looking spooky out here.
Yo, TB Bay is supposed to call me, man. Like, let me know what you're feeling in the room. Let me know how you're feeling in the room. Y'all want TP Bay to call up? You know, that's the homie that sucker punch Meek Mill or knocked him out, whatever you want to call it. Y'all want to hear from TP Bay? Say yes, say no. You know, let me know.
Let's be honest, guys. The news cycle's been fucking slow for the past few days, right?
It's trash on the internet right now.
Trash. There's not enough going on. Somebody needs to get knocked out. We need a lot of things to happen, okay? We need some.
Oh, they want to hear from him. They want to hear from TV Bay.
I want to hear from TV Bay too. I want to see what's. I want to talk to TV Bay. I want to get answers. I want the answers. Like, why?
So y'all got to lead on Patreons. Y'all want to hear from TV Bay? Lead on Patreons, man. Because, you know, we might have an exclusive where he might have to be here live for me. So I might send him an Uber or something from New York to Philly. So send him Patreons in, and I'm going to get TV Bay to shout you out. I have TV Bay here with me. On some exclusive shit, yeah.
Yo, you know what we need, and we need to pray for Haiti, pray for the Bahamas, the Caribbean. They got.
Oh yeah, let's pray for all that.
Yo, they going through a crazy thing right now. Yeah, that hurricane's blasting through.
What's the name of the hurricane?
Matthew. It's headed this way. It's gonna come up the Florida coast, come up Georgia, boomerang back out to sea.
Yo, Hurricane Matthew, better calm your motherfucking ass down, man.
Now, Hurricane Matthew, we need to go back out to sea and get
fall
out.
Fall back, Matthew.
Yeah, fall back. Haiti. Pray for Cuba. Haiti.
Pray for Florida. It's in Florida right now, right?
I think it's going through Haiti and it's about to hit Florida, right? Like, parts of it are hitting. Nova Glover, what up? Avery Walton. Woo! What's up,
Matt, bro, what up?
I want to see if somebody left the Patreon. I'm checking that Patreon right now, live. I'm checking that Patreon, Rec.
I'm lit. Checking that Patreon.
Oh, we got a dollar from James Moore.
Oh,
shout out to you.
All donations.
But you know you could do 10. You know you could do 20.
What's his name?
Avery Moore. This is James Moore.
James Moore. Salute. We appreciate that.
We appreciate the dollar. But you know you could do 10.
So we some dollar niggas? That's what you...
What am I, a dollar store?
We some dollar dudes?
I'm a dollar store?
I see you.
No, we appreciate it.
We appreciate that. I'm just fucking with y'all. I'm just trying to bring some light to the room and shit, because y'all in there. Yo, 21 Savage, what's up? I'm kind of used to you being a savage.
Yo, guys, I just got an email from the Federal Aviation Administration. If you don't know, I am certified drone pilot. I'm a certified drone pilot, okay? They're saying it's a $32,000 violation if you fly near that hurricane. Don't fly near the hurricane.
How much, they said?
32 grand. How are they going to even know? The drone's out of here. It's over.
So they don't want nobody getting that footage. That's basically what it is.
Yeah, they don't want us to know that they make the hurricanes.
They don't want... See, you know, my boy JT got an ill-ass drone. He could fly that shit right now and get that footage of that hurricane. They don't want JT getting footage of the Hurricane Matthew putting it on his live stream.
They don't want me to be great. Yo, guys, should we do a live stream one day with the drone?
Les, what up?
The live stream with the drone will be live.
That'd be crazy.
We could do it.
Yo, this live stream lit tonight. Stop playing. Salute, y'all.
I'm flexing. It's 21 Savage. I'm flexing on my ex.
I'm flexing 21 Savage. I got some guns, too. I'll be cool, but my shit crazy.
Yo, you lit tonight, right?
I got some guns, too. Don't fuck around.
Yo, Florida. You know Florida. Everybody pray for Florida. Okay, let's get back to the French Montana.
Florida.
Yo, if you're late to the broadcast, we're getting back into French Montana. And we're letting you know that the label has told him you ain't coming out with no mac and cheese 4. It's over. Yo, 21 Savage. I heard 22 Savage coming for you, bro.
M. Dude, what up? Salute. Julio. Nah, I don't do nothing. I don't work out or nothing, man. That's my natural shit. I'll probably get that for my pops.
Yo, Rec, what'd you eat last night? I ate Chinese food.
22 revolvers? Nah, my shit like more like fucking 3-pound 7s. This shit look crazy. Stop playing, dope. You don't want none of... You don't want these pythons in your neck.
I'm going to sit down for the rest of this broadcast.
I ate fish. I had fish yesterday, Jordan. I hear you. I'm just fucking with them in the chat room.
You crazy over there, bro.
What's good? Low key, 100.
MREC TV.
MREC TV, we in here, baby. Daily Hip Hop Live with Jordan Tower. This is my guy. This is my guy.
So, Rec, I ordered some Chinese food last night. I had chicken wings. I had the shrimp cashew, and I had the shrimp egg rolls.
Oh, you ate good.
It was a good night.
You ate like a boss.
I mean, you know, I didn't feel like cooking last night.
I feel you.
I should go to the store tonight and cook. I'm thinking tacos. I'm thinking chicken tacos.
Okay. Nice.
What you gonna eat tonight, Rick?
Full circle. What up? I don't even know what I'm gonna eat, truthfully, man. I eat out every night, man. I had fish yesterday and I ate out. Even when I get at home cooking, I still eat out. That shit crazy, right?
That's crazy.
I might do the Spanish spot. They got the spot called El Rey's in East New York, Brooklyn, and yeah, I'm promoting them. And I'm going to make them sponsor us, too, so don't get it twisted.
Who are you going to make sponsor us?
El Rey. It's a spot. It's a Spanish spot. They cook Spanish food.
You think they're going to give us that Fabulous. Dough?
They definitely going to sponsor us. Okay. Shouts to all my man in the spot. What's
rice and beans. Yo, Julio Rivera, I love rice and beans, but you know what? I would get so fucking fat off rice and beans. Like, look how fat I am right now.
Rotisserie chicken.
Do you want to see me at 300 pounds, man?
Steak, yellow rice and beans.
Yo, Rec, I gotta get back on. I gotta get back on my shit, bro. I gotta get back to working out, man. I'm really like, I'm off my game right now.
Salute. Nah, I go to the L-Ray in East New York. A Deadly Wishable. They closed down a spot in Bushwick.
Yo, Trill Life said Jordan about to say fuck MREC in a minute. Why would I do that? That's my boy. We just chilling, man. This is that part of the broadcast where we just kick it. It's the last 10 minutes.
Hold on, Mike. You trying to disrespect me. You know the wolves going to turn on you in that chat room. You know what I'm saying? Mike, you better be easy. The wolves is in that chat room. I turn my wolves on you.
Yo, guys, you like how I have that chat going right on the live stream so you guys can just see yourselves? Like, that shit's dope, right? Let me make you guys bigger so you guys can see yourselves. Look at you guys. You guys are live. Nobody's bought a t-shirt yet, guys. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm not a liar.
It's getting spooky, man. It's we got some spooky shirts. Yo, Wildin', go get them shirts, man. DailyHipHopShot.com.
Like yo, shout out to Turk for the heavy promo.
Oh, Turk went crazy.
Turk went crazy on the promo.
The French Montana dude, he in here calling me a sucker. I know French Montana personally.
That guy, French Montana.
Jacking his name. How about that?
No, French Montana is heavy on my channel.
I talk crazy now. Like, I be chilling with y'all, but y'all can't out-talk crazy me. I talk crazy.
French Montana. Now, the guy French Montana, he's cool in here because...
Mike Montana, some loot. Tell him put some respect on my name.
Yo, Jordan stepping his game up. Lamar Allen, how am I stepping? I'm just trying to chill right now.
First of all, ain't nobody begging for money. Anytime when you provide a service...
Yeah.
You're supposed to either get sponsored or you get investors. If you look at the presidential campaign, Trump is a billionaire, so is Hillary.
Yep, and they're asking for donations. Why can't we?
Every day, they ask for donations.
Guys, we're just trying. Guys, we this is what we do, okay?
Do your homework.
We entertain you guys. We're here for you guys every day. You can't deny that. Look it, we're 3 weeks strong right now, Rick, right?
Every day.
So you guys got to support the broadcast, man. You know, send us 10, 20 bucks.
Everything. I be thirsty.
You know why? And you guys, we're not going out with the fucking Patreon money and being like, yo, so what are we going to eat tonight? You know what we're doing with that money? We're reinvesting in the damn broadcast.
Come on, Allen. I take this shit serious. Salute.
Reinvesting.
John Hancock, salute.
You got to reinvest in yourself.
Ain't nobody crooked over here.
I'm going to read you guys some inspiration right now. You guys ready?
Julio, don't worry about it. That's what they do. We take all donations. French Montana, you about to get blocked.
Nah. Don't block it. He's cool. He's all right.
And we talking about French Montana in the chat room.
Yeah, but he supports, though.
Oh, he supports? All right. He better not talk crazy. He about to get blocked.
But he's another 21 Savage, bro.
Okay, he's just trolling, just for attention. Okay,
he's cool.
21 Savage don't even be on the Savage shit no more, so I got to salute.
He'd be on it. He was telling me he loved me earlier.
Oh, damn. Spooky.
It's real spooky, but it's all good.
Spooky!
Okay, let's analyze some quotes, okay? Do one thing every day that scares you. What do you think about that?
Hold on. Say it again. I'm sorry.
Do one thing every day that scares you.
The only thing that scares me that I want to do every day.
I'm going to be honest with you guys. One thing I do every day that scares me is YouTube. I don't know what tomorrow is with YouTube.
You're right.
YouTube isn't promised tomorrow, so that's scary. Okay, how about this? We are what we pretend to be, so we must be careful about what we pretend to be. Woo! Mm. Look at Meek Mill. Pretending to be a gangster. Is that true? Does that pertain to Meek Mill?
I don't know.
Meek Mill is a gangster. He grew up in the hood. Okay? He keeps it 100. But, like, let's not go out here and pretend you're a mobster. A lot of rappers do that. I'm not saying Meek Mill right now. Okay? Let's talk about who's one of the fakest, Rick, that we could talk about.
I mean, there's a lot of these fake fuckers.
Who's locked up now over being something that they weren't?
They want attention in here because you know... You
can I be honest, bro? Record, this is how I look at it. Yo.
I never claim to be gangster, but...
I'm going to be like
trust
this.
Me, never look was
at,
no
look,
sucker.
Look at the situation Troy Ave's in right now, okay?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of things led up to that confrontation that made him have to pull a gun out. Okay,
His hand was forced in that situation, though. I would say that. You know what I mean? His hand was definitely forced.
Yeah, but like something happened before that for someone else to try his man. You know, guys, just be you. Don't pretend to be anybody else. That's just what it is. Okay. Sometimes you wake up. Sometimes the fall kills you. And sometimes when you fall, you fly. That's so real, guys. Sometimes you got to fall flat on your face to get back up, try again, and win a different way.
Facts.
That's real facts. Talk. When we love, we always strive to become better than what we are. When we strive to become better than we are, everything around us becomes better too. That's hard. That's from The Alchemist. That is not the producer.
I'm letting you read your motivational quotes.
These are powerful, bro. The flower that blooms in adversity is the rarest.
On my regular shit, gag.
You drunk as hell right now, bro.
Nah, I'm chilling, baby.
Nah, you drunk, bro.
Never get drunk.
Never get drunk.
I leave that for the bitches.
Whoa.
I let the bitches get drunk and tell Shorty, nah, I'm good on you.
I'm gonna bookmark this page. This is a good quote.
Salute,
bro.
Julio. It's my this is a custom. This is a Get Wreck Apparel. Grind plus hustle equal grussle. This is classic. Salute.
What's the Twitter? What's the link for your hip hop shop? Oh, it's right there, bro. Support us. Let me check that Patreon.
And it's under the video.
How do you buy t-shirts? You go to the Daily Hip Hop Shop and you buy a t-shirt.
Yeah, that Henny was hitting 40. I ain't gonna front. I mean,
why do you like Hennessy like that?
I don't even drink like that too. I just did it because I said, yo, I want to be lit for the live stream today for y'all. So send them Patreons in, man. If y'all like that, you said M-Rec look like Prince. Yeah, I fuck with that purple. 21 Savage, I fuck with that. Make me laugh on some funny shit, not no hating shit. I like that. I'm on my Prince shit right now.
Yo, guys, I want to see one more Patreon before this broadcast is over. Somebody go in there, make a nice donation, 10, 20 bucks. Let's keep the Patreons going so at least we're getting 40.
Are you going Henny straight? I'm sorry. Yeah, get the Patreon on. I'm reading.
It's all good.
Nah, I ain't go to Boys and Girls. I'm at the Old Emotive. You know where it's real. Nothing but dudes in there. And it was like four.
Whoa,
four
that sounds spooky, bro.
No, it was only four chicks and two of them. I had the baddest two. So how about that? It was East New York, Brownsville, Fort Greene.
Sounds spooky.
It was the wildest. Boroughs in there, all Brooklyn. And you already know, man, I had that automotive thing on lock. Ask anybody.
Yo, this is getting spooky.
Huh? This is a fact.
I'm scared.
Yeah, I heard that before. People did tell me I look like AZ. Shouts to AZ, the visualizer. He from East New York, too. We out here, Jays.
Yo,
East
someone said Embrek bragging about all dudes in there.
Salute. Julio, you a G too.
Guys, what's your favorite porn star?
Back with a Kush. I don't smoke, but I do it for the room. If y'all want me to blow some Kush, I do it for the room. Fuck it. Next broadcast, I light it up for the room. That's what y'all want.
Guys, what's your favorite porn star?
Yeah, name your favorite porn star.
Someone said you ain't BK.
Oh, Prince O'Mill tried to diss me. It's cool.
Rhett Kogan, Sarah J.
It's something about Sarah J. She, whoo.
I'm going to tell you, mine's Veronica Rodriguez. She's dope.
I'm going to tell you, what's the chick name? Khalifa,
she's
something
nice.
Was her name?
Well, Mia Khalifa's dope. But
Mia Khalifa,
yo,
super bad.
My girl, but my favorite porn star is my girl.
Yeah, mine's too.
That's my top porn star, my girlfriend.
My girl's a super porn star.
I love my girl. But we all have our favorite porn stars that we watch from time to time on
That's the political correct answer right there.
Nah, that's real, though. I love my girl, man. Nobody does it like your girl. A porn star
that's
is a porn star.
Girls in the chat room.
Your girl's in the chat room?
Nah, your girl's in the chat room.
No, she's not. Beautiful duo, Amber Rose. Someone said Amber Rose.
Kind of bad. I seen her in person. Like, her videos and pictures don't do nothing for her. Like, in person? Shit.
M-Rec looked at JT crazy. JT in love. Sophia the body.
Yeah, she got a body.
Avery Walton was good, bro. Yeah, we appreciate you guys coming in here every day, man.
Word, man. Fucking with us, man. We having fun, man. We been in here how long?
Over an hour right now.
Yeah, and we just fucking with y'all, man. Like, we having fun. It's slow on the internet. Yo, y'all need to share that that Hot Boy Turk interview from, you know, Jordan Tower and MREC TV. You know what I'm saying? Share those interviews and those loops.
Yeah.
Share those, you know, because Turk was in here with y'all live. Y'all got to respect that. Put some respect on it.
No, that was hard.
You feel me?
Turk showed love.
We bringing dudes in here live.
Live and direct.
With his kids wilding out in the background. Yo, John Hancock, salute, man. The professional chiller. Yeah, it goes hard, man. Salute. Appreciate you. Got MREC Rustler series coming soon, too. Jordan Tower, he's definitely going to be filming and directing that with me. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to go down to Atlanta and film some scenes.
Yo, what's up with
I don't look like no Jim Brown. Cut it out.
Do fucking do people are people feeling Young Ma beyond ooh? What do you think?
I don't know, man. You know she's doing her thing. Salute to Young Ma.
Kim Kardashian takes a month off and attempts to scale back on social media. Please, man. Then look at this. You know what Kim Kardashian has said too? She said. She fears naked pictures and sex tapes are going to start leaking. Like, what? You guys are setting it up for a media storm and trying to blame it on the fucking robbery? Get the fuck out of here. These guys, it's looking spooky out here. It's
looking spooky.
John Mayer and Kanye West.
Oh, you got somebody asking about your editing. How much it costs? Lamar.
Everything. Allen. Everything pretty much starts off at like $1,000.
$1,000
editing.
Man.
For editing, because it's time consuming, man. And you know my time is valuable.
And that's still Jordan Tower editing your shit.
Yeah, I'll make your shit look 20 million times better than you did. You might have filmed it on your
mixtape coming out.
Oh shit, we still gotta edit that video. We keep getting sidetracked.
Edit that video. I'm gonna drop a mixtape for y'all. Probably on my birthday, November 16th. So check for that.
Cover Young Ma. She's more popping. Q-Medicine. Time is money.
On iTunes and go to MREC TV. Y'all see some audio.
Yo,
some
guys.
Visuals.
Someone said A Boogie is better. A Boogie is a knockoff of Dej Loaf. Let's just be honest, okay? I can only be honest. I like A Boogie's song. Don't get me wrong. Any new low stuff?
Scorpio.
I drop a new low thing every day. I got another one. I got some
Scorpios in the room. The homie Les, the homie Julio. No wonder why we connected like that. Scorpio, November 16th.
Pest control was better than new, of course. JT needs some Henny and Red Bull. Nah, because I'll go to sleep. Right now, I'm tired. Like, when I go live with you guys, I give you guys my best hour of the day, honestly. That's why you need to hit that Patreon.
That's the homie. I'm going to put that call in.
JT, what's your resume? Just go on my YouTube channel, man. I'm tired. I can't break down my whole resume right now. JT,
you
need a cup of coffee.
You got some hot beats? I only fuck with heat.
Yo, I can't drink no more coffee today. I'll be up all night, man. I drink a lot.
The Ike Beats, Scorpio, November 4th. Salute. Scorpios, what's up?
I can't drink no more coffee, guys.
Yo, for beats, you know what I mean? Oh, y'all want to send me donations
JT's
for,
peak
like,
hours. JT.
Y'all
want to
send me donations for the MREC mixtape and all that? GutterMusic@gmail.com and beats. GutterMusic@gmail.com. You heard?
Word.
That's only for business only for business only.
Go to bed, JT. Let REC handle this for now. Should I do that?
Nah, we good. We rocking. Like, the fake French Montana dude wants some attention, man. See, dude's gonna light your ass up. You talking crazy. Talking about Scorpio's low-key gay.
Yo,
exactly.
But
let's get at.
Yo, why are you going at people in the chat room?
Nah, he coming for me.
Yeah, but just let him.
Nah, but fuck that.
Yo, you on some other shit right now, bro.
Yeah, I'm on some other shit. Son can't come in talking
JT,
crazy.
JT, where the fuck you at? I'm right here, Charlie Wingate. I'm just chilling.
You gonna walk in my shit talking crazy. You in my shit.
Why is someone named themselves Charlie Wingate after Max V? You guys are crazy.
Oh, 21 see. Savage gonna tear him apart.
Someone said something to me. I just can't
like
read it.
Like MREC lit for once. I'll be too calm. All right, salute. Nah.
Pick
put a C with that K
is. You up, JT. You gotta pick a subject. I'm sorry.
GUTTAMUZIC at Gmail. No K.
Yo, I'm tired as hell right now.
You yawning over there, Jordan? Get up, nigga. Stop playing.
I'm trying.
Come on, stop playing.
Yeah, I just set up a whole YouTube channel today, like beginning to end with for Wendy Day.
Yeah. Now you put in that work.
That was hard, bro. I'm gonna be honest. But Wendy Day deserves it.
Mm.
That's family.
I'm lit for y'all, man.
Yeah, Rex picking up my... I gave you my energy already. I gave you all my energy.
Now I'm having a good day.
This is real reality TV.
I'm just on my shit today, you know what I mean?
Can you imagine if we... Can you imagine if we went live for 24 hours?
I could do it. Nah, it ain't too late, John Hancock. Send that in, homie.
I couldn't do it. JT wants to crash. Just let MREC take over. Yo, I'm going to be honest with you. MREC deserves to be the big screen right now. He's kind of lit. I'm going to give it you bigger, Rec.
Nah, it's all good. I could be.
You big right now.
My regular window.
Nah, I just made you the big window.
Oh, what? What's that happening, huge. Y'all? Salute. Peace.
Let me see if I can move you around a little bit. Put you ahead. There you go. Now I'll be the feature. I'm the side. No, I'm just joking.
Yo, let me ask y'all something.
What's up?
What y'all feeling about that Luke Cage? Cause that shit.
Oh, you
fire.
Watch more of that?
That shit fire.
I didn't watch any.
Julio, I don't know what I'm eating for dinner, man.
JT need a shot of Patron.
Yeah, he needs something. He's sleeping on a job over there.
I'm chilling, bro. I'm like the little guy now. I just
Oh, they got Charlie Wingate in there. Max B, salute. Luke
Why
Cage
isn't there
song.
A conversation happening? Okay, Rec, let's talk about something.
They fucking with that Luke Cage. Look. Everybody said Luke Cage is dope. Some say, all right, Luke Cage corny. Oh, that's French Montana. Fake French Montana. I knew he would say that. Luke Cage is fire.
JT, stop being a square. JT, you need a shot of Patron. Should I go get a glass of wine right now?
Yo, Jordan on the live stream yawning. Fuck
yo,
you doing?
Yo, but let's be honest. I'm not going to the gym tonight, am I? I'm too tired, right? Yo, Rec, you know what? I'm going to join you in a drink.
Hold on. It said Luke Cage. Not to cut you off. They said Luke Cage crashed Netflix.
Yo, can I tell you something? Yo, Rec, can you fucking listen to me for a second? Yo,
yeah,
Rec. Yo, listen to me. Yo.
I'm listening.
Yo, you lit
what, you
right now. But
You want me to look at you? That shit is spooky right there.
I want you to look at me. Yeah, look at me in my eyes, bro.
All right, look, I'm gonna take my hat off. You get spooky over there. She can got a funny style.
Yo,
man.
I'm gonna go get a glass of wine. I want you to understand that.
Glass of wine? You gonna talk to me about a glass of wine? That shit sounds.
Yo, you talking about wine?
Wine?
You talking about wine?
Look what Nova Global said.
Yo, someone said now, gay. He said I'm gay. Yo, what should I go get? Yo, I'm gonna. Okay, I was surprised you was nothing. Hold on.
Spooky. This is spooky. Sus.
No, it's not sus, bro.
Yo, Hitty Face Rec, I'm fucking with y'all. Julio, what up? Yeah, wine. Nah, Henny. I'm fucking with y'all.
I don't drink Henny.
Now, my hairline ain't fucked up. Don't get it twisted. You see, my shit popping like I'm 14. My motherfucking points on point, all that. You wildin'. You just wanted to see my hairline, dude. And that's spooky. I'm putting my hat back on. Spooky! Shouts to my man Rob Murder for the spooky. That's his shit. he's fucking with Jim Jones and all that. He's in a professional chiller. You know what I'm saying? Spooky!
Shut up.
You know? I know the headline thing was a joke, but you see my shit correct though, right? Your favorite rapper shit is twisted. You know what I'm saying? Name some of your rappers who headlines is twisted, who always keep their hats on. Let's do that. Name some of your rappers who never keep their hats on.
Yo, 50 Cent, holla at us, man. 50 Cent, holla at us, man.
Jordan got that effing.
We need this. We need a sponsor from effing, man.
Effing better send that in. Stop playing. Because this man drinking wine over there. He ain't even trying to crack that effing. He drinking wine. Red wine.
Yo, look at.
Design our us.
Yo, guys, look.
Your hairline is spooky.
Yo, what's
LeBron James hairline never at. Look at my shit. LeBron want my hairline. LeBron hollered at me, say he want five. He trying to send me 5 minutes for my hairline.
Let's do a little effing commercial. Yo, effing. I love it. It's delicious. I love effing.
Plies hairline.
Effing. It's delicious. Yo, guys, we're doing an extra long broadcast today. You know why? Because Rex lit right now.
Crazy lit.
Who drank that cucumber? Who drank that cucumber? But this is that other shit. This isn't even wine. This is like cheap box wine.
Do y'all know about that MREC and China Black All In record? That's on MREC TV, the video. Go check that out. All In, the best record you ever heard. Male and female going back and forth with bars, metaphors, similes, double entendres. Let me know if y'all heard that MREC All In. Stop playing. Fuck these other rappers.
Lamar Allen, I'm sipping. You know what this is, Rec? It's Manischewitz wine, the cheapest wine you could buy.
Oh, you heard it? Of course. Avery, what up? Les, what up? See? Fire, Julio, what up? Salute. All In, MREC, Channel Black. Fire, bar.
Yo, you guys are going to turn MREC into an alcoholic because now he's all turned up. He thinks he's got to be turned up every broadcast.
Yeah, we got to interview some bad bitches. I agree, Mike. I fuck with Money and Balance, but I fuck with that professional chiller because I'm in it.
Yo.
I fuck with anything I'm involved in. See, that's one thing about me.
Yo, Manischewitz is delicious, man. I'm going to be honest. This is that, I think this is the grape one.
You on here drinking wine. You fucking up the whole vibe.
Damn, Jordan playing the sideline. I have to today. Rex turned up.
Yo, my man drinking fucking wine. Like, what's going on? What kind of wine is that?
Manischewitz, bro.
What?
Manischewitz. It's cheap.
And your dog just barked on you because he know that wine was bullshit. Soon as you said that wine, he got valid.
JT being fancy. I'm a fancy kind of guy, baby.
Yo, I didn't even see that young Lito, man. I was going to watch it, but part itself, good looking. I'm going to watch it in a little bit.
See the glass I got, too? I got a little gay glass.
Oh, you said it.
JT looked like a 40-year-old woman. See, someone said JT looked like a 40-year-old woman.
Yo, if I was in your crib, I'd break that fucking wine glass.
Yo, guys, you know what's gonna... Yo, Nova Glover, stop calling... Chill out, bro. My middle name might be Day, but I ain't no gay.
Smancy.
Talk
yo,
about
don't
the
never
hurricane.
Drink that wine glass around
yo,
me. I'm
okay,
gonna break that shit in like 80,
someone wants
feet.
Us to talk about the hurricane. Okay, so the hurricane... It's coming.
Oh, I got something to say. What? Don't ever drink that wine glass around me. I'm going to break that shit in 80,000 pieces. It's my man, though.
Chill out, Ray.
Nah, I'm chilling.
Professionally.
Yeah, I am.
Professionally?
Smoke, y'all.
JT.
Killer pole.
JT just got the really drone fun. With PTA meeting. Now he unwinding.
What was the most gooned out interview? I don't know. I don't look at these rappers as goons. I'm be honest with you. These niggas is not goons to me.
I got a gooned out interview when I was in Far Rockaway and someone pulled a gun out and cocked it back and some dust came out of it and I thought I was dead. Gooned out.
Shit, little did y'all know, a lot of your favorite rappers, I had to, you know, hold them down on a lot of different shit. I'm going to leave it as that. You know what I'm saying? These niggas is not what they pretend to be.
Let's talk about M-Rec versus Papoose.
Nah, that's the homie.
No, I'm just fucking with you.
Me and Pat did a record, you know what I'm saying? And he put it on his mixtape, and you know, I caught a lot of fans off that.
Was this pre Remy Home?
Yeah, it was the King of New York mixtape. It was called Caught Up, M-Rec and Papoose.
Jeezy just released a new track. Yo, I'm kind of cool on Jeezy right now. I wanna hear some more. You know, like. Jeezy's my favorite artist too, but like, I don't know, man.
It said my mouth moving like a Chinese flick. I guess my shit's stalling. Is it?
Looks good now. It was for a minute, but
you're good. It was?
Yeah.
It's Jordan over there. He always blaming me.
What? My shit's fucked up too.
Your software over there is on a fritz.
Sometimes you know what? I didn't restart my computer before the broadcast. That's probably the problem.
Julio's a G. I never saw somebody who saluted me and told me that they moms was digging me. I respect Julio for that. That was some real G shit.
Yo, guys, like, you know what you got to do? Let's get people to go over to Wendy Day's channel. This is Wendy Day. Go over there, check out the new video. She's up and running now, guys. If you want music advice, this is Wendy Day.
Shout out to Wendy Day. Official. Hold on. Somebody asked me a question. M-Rec, do you think Nas and AZ get their credit for hip-hop? I think Nas do. I think AZ is underrated. You know, AZ is like, if he's not there with Nas, he's like maybe like a step under Nas. He's right there. Lyrically, he's right there. Flows, AZ got one of the best flows in hip-hop. And bars is crazy. I think he's underrated, though.
Make sure you support us, guys. Hit that Patreon.
I'm from East New York. I'm underrated too, but fuck it. What you gonna do?
Damn, Turk's going crazy with the videos.
You know what I'm saying? Nas is one of my favorites, if not the favorite. I'm about to get more Turk than Rap. Ghost in the Wind, what's happening? AZ got the billionaire wife. Got that billionaire wife? Well, I don't know why. Mano scared Whack 100. I don't know what's going on with that. I heard they squashed it.
Yeah, they squashed that beef.
Wasn't AZ beefing with the real AZ? I heard because of the whole Sugar Hill shit, too. Yeah, I did hear that. B-Mac on his shit. Pink Houses, I always go to Pink Houses. That was where all my homies was from. You know what I'm saying? We used to go from Automotive back at Pink Houses to my man Kwan crib. I used to always hang in Pink Houses. Still go through there every once in a while. That's like 10 blocks away. I'm in East New York right now. What's happening? Mixtapes on that Piff? Yeah. But I really push my shit on iTunes. But you can go to that Piff and rap. Live mixtapes. You know what I'm saying? Luke Cage is live. Ken Blood, what up? See, I be shouting niggas. Jordan be shouting dudes.
Lamar Allen, Full Circle. Nova Glover, even though you said I'm gay.
Jackie Robinson, PJs.
Kim Blood, Lamar Allen, Billy Parker. Ghost with the Wind. Avery Wilson. I'm going to be in Pink House this Saturday. All right, cool. Jordan having a nervous breakdown. Now I'm just tired, guys.
Full Circle, I rap. Go to MREC TV, man. Go check that all in. You check that all in? It's going to be the best record you ever heard. And then you got that Power Freestyle put out like 2 weeks ago. Fire.
What you think about Star?
Star's the homie. I fuck with
him. Tupac MF is Doom?
I don't listen to MF Doom, but I'm going to check him out, though. He definitely got a track record. I definitely need to, you know what I'm saying? Salute to MF Doom.
Oh, someone said Famous Dex is the worst. You think martial law will start JT? Of course.
Zach Morris, salute. Thank you. All in is that
martial
shit.
Law is definitely going to start. Jordan is asleep at the wheel tonight. I mean, guys, I gave you my best hour. Someone said, Jordan, turn up. Yo, guys, I gave you an hour.
Yo, go cop that All In off iTunes, man. It's all good to listen to it on my YouTube, see the video, but go cop that, man. Shit is $1.
How much, Lamar Allen said, how much do we charge for promotion? JordanTowerFilms@gmail.com. Hit me up. We'll work it out.
Hit him up. We're going to work it out.
Want to get over 300,000 views on your shit?
Holly. I got the MREC Paper Chaser, too. That's fire on my channel. Go check that out. MREC Power. Was it episode 10 finale freestyle? Check that out. Fire.
Someone said you need to promote more artists. We got to get paid to promote. Yo, JT on some Khaled shit. How was that?
Like this? All right.
Effing. I'm effing tired right now.
Yeah, we going to get up with y'all tomorrow, man. I got to make some moves. Shouts to Effin. JT was on his wine shit tonight. You know, I'm on my Henny. You feel
Yo,
me?
Yo, 50. It ain't going to be that much to sponsor this broadcast, bro. I like the cucumber. It's
we
delicious.
Need a podcast. Send them Patreons in, homie. Killer Cole. Appreciate you, though. Salute.
Someone, yo, everybody go tweet 50 and tell him to sponsor this broadcast. We got F.
Some guy, yeah, do the knowledge, man.
Hip,
once
hip.
You hear that all in, you're going to understand that MREC is probably one of the best.
Yo, E-Mob, drink that effing. 50, holla.
Hear that Paper Chaser. I mean, I got so many joints. Hear that freestyle. But I ain't trying to force my music on y'all. Y'all just check it out yourself. MREC TV, y'all go through it.
All right, guys, time to end this broadcast.
Yeah, we off this, man.
We appreciate you. Love this podcast. Definitely.
Trill for life. Yo, 23, 40, slow.
So 40C said he's definitely going to donate. 40C, donate tonight, man. Please.
Donate that, man. We're going
to
shout you out.
We need to make our mark for the week.
Billy Parker, I appreciate that, man. The All In is crazy. I really do this music shit, man. Thanks, y'all. On some real shit.
Someone said, fuck, I missed it. What are they talking about? We're going to have a rebroadcast. And we're on tomorrow, too, right, Rick?
Friday payday. Okay. That sounds good. Yeah, we on tomorrow, too. Peace, Julio. God bless,
what time
man.
Let's ask him, what time should we go live tomorrow?
Probably go live tomorrow about 6:30.
Let's ask them. What time?
What time y'all want us to go live? What time work for y'all? We on your time. What time y'all want before we leave? What time y'all want us to go live tomorrow?
I'm waiting. What's up, guys?
I guess they left the room. Fuck them.
They ain't leave. I'm out with family tomorrow. 10 p.m. I ain't going out at 10 p.m. tomorrow night, man.
Nah. I see 6:30, 6, 8 p.m., 7:30, 8, 10, 3 a.m. You a savage. 21 savage. 6, 7. So far, I see 6, 7, 7:30.
We'll
so
go around
gonna do,
7.
We're going to do 7 o'clock. We do about 7. Is 7 good, y'all?
Let's do 7.
We're going to do 7 then.
I'm waiting to see another Patreon come in. I don't see none.
7 it is, y'all. So 7 o'clock. Promote that. Tomorrow. Jordan gonna have this shit ready early. We gonna have this shit ready early. 7 o'clock. We going live.
Did Beans
Friday.
Drop the video today?
Huh?
Did Beans drop a video today?
I don't know. Ghost in the wind, 5 a.m. today.
Yo, would you guys watch me
6:30 works? We gonna do 7, man. Cause 7, it seems like everybody agreed on 7.
Would you guys watch me sleep right
Looking
now?
Looking for the truth, 7, man. How that works? Sorry, Jordan. What you say?
I'm asking them if they would watch me sleep if I went to sleep right now.
That's spooky right there. That's kind of... I'm going to leave that up to the room.
I get
the court.
Paid once a month. That's what they said.
Okay.
JT, smack off that Flint water.
7, you can eat and watch the show, no doubt. I appreciate that, you know, especially when y'all tune in, y'all say y'all eat and watch the show. Somebody said they was getting head while watching the show. I wouldn't do that, but fuck it. If that's what you're doing, you know what I'm saying? You long as you tune in, just long as you don't do no homo shit, you know what I'm saying? That's spooky.
Yeah.
40C, exactly. Spooky. Tay Lay, 1100, spooky. The Bean Song's fire. We was talking about that all day. Sun God, where you been at? You just came in? Bean Song fire. Yeah, somebody said they was getting head like 2 days ago to the live stream. That was spooky. But you know, salute. If that's what they want to do, fuck it. Niggas jacking off watching us. That's spooky.
Very spooky. Beans whispers the whole song. All right, guys, we out this motherfucker.
Yo, we out, fam. Salute, y'all. 7 tomorrow. Lock in, 7 p.m. Promote that. Like and share. MREC TV. Daily Hip Hop Live. We gone. Patreon. Go click that.
We're still alive. Hold on, I got it.
Peace. Peace. Check that all in. Peace. Hit that Patreon. Peace. Daily Hip Hop Shop. Go get some shirts. Peace. I'm gone. MREC. Jordan Tower. Peace.
I'm trying to get your window back right. Moving you around. All right, now I got to get your logo back over your face.
Oh, wow. You fucking up.
Nah, I had your big window.
I'm a Patreon. Okay.
I'm waiting.
Send that Patreon. Salute, my guy. Tay Lay, 1100. If y'all entertain, man, send that Patreon, man. So I can keep getting drinks. I stay lit. Your Patreons, I'm going to sponsor my drinks. Your Patreon's going to sponsor my drinks so I can stay lit for y'all. How about that?
Drink champs?
Nah, we ain't on drink champ shit. Shouts to them. Shouts to Nori and all that, but I'm the first rapper who made this interview shit look cool, and I'm gonna keep it a billion. Been doing this shit a million, but you know, it is what it is. Nori the homie. Nori let me open up for him, so I can never, but I'm just calling what it is. I'm the first rapper to make this interview shit look cool. Check my work. Sun God, listen to that music. Billy Parker, what up?
Man, I'm tired.
21 Savage said, fuck BX niggas trying to rob him. Damn, you went to the BX and they stripped you? It's fucked up. They stripped you. Them BX niggas stripped you naked? That's fucked up, my guy.
I'm tired as hell right now.
King Blood, check that music, man. And make sure y'all cop that off iTunes too, man. It's good to play, but make sure, you know, support that. We're gonna get that Mac soon too.
It's 9 o'clock, I'm the dot, I'm in my drop top, cruising the street.
The street.
I got a pretty, pretty young down.
The BX niggas are savages for real, 21 Savage. Those some real savages out there in the BX. They fuck with us heavy, too.
Someone said, what you think about the state property cipher?
I thought it was dope.
I'll tell you one thing about it. Meek didn't set that up. They don't need Meek to set
that up. I thought it was dope. Petey Crack and Beans killed it. I mean, I thought everybody did their thing, truthfully. I mean, from what I heard, it's a Neef Buck song they redid. I think Freeway and Beans had new verses, but Sean Price is, that was my heart. R.P. Sean Price, that was my guy. One of the nicest rappers, period. Falls like bars, Sean Price, dumb nice. R.P. Sean Price, my brother.
Sean Price, go dumb nice. I'm really tired. 9 o'clock.
R.P. Sean Price.
It's been a long day.
Yeah, Knee Buck, Game of Thrones, Sprite Prince.
It's been a long day.
Chicago niggas stay with the 40 Cavs, then. No doubt. Billy Parker, good looking. Sun God, R.P. Sean Price. Salute.
Salute.
They still in the room. Fuck it. We still fucking with y'all.
It's kind of falling off, though.
Nigga, I've been rapping. I don't give a fuck how long I've been rapping. See, that's the problem with y'all.
Prince said, fuck it, I got no out.
I love this music shit. Down to live streaming with y'all, man. Music and talking to the fans. I love this shit. I don't give a fuck if I was rapping since 1936. Who gives a fuck? I love music. I'll be 100,000 years old rapping. That's right. And still be nice with the bars. See? Sun God salute. See? He went to go check it. See what that man said? Yo, you kind of nice, bro, with them bars. Salute. Salute. Appreciate that. Be Mac.
Damn, RIP to 283 people in Haiti. 283 people dead.
What?
Damn.
283 people in Haiti died?
Or
264. Wow. That's crazy, man. I got mad people in Haiti. That's fucked up, man. That shit kind of fucked up my night, yo. Yo, I'm going to close out on that, man, because I got mad people in Haiti, man. Some real shit, y'all. Yo, Prince, I do that tomorrow. That shit kind of fucked me up because I got a lot of peoples in Haiti, man. Like, damn, man. RP to all the people in Haiti, my condolences, man. I got to make some calls now. That's crazy. That shit just fucked me up.
All right, man.
All right, George, man. I'm out, man. Peace. Haiti, man. Hold up.
RIP, peace, Haiti. RIP to the people that died in Haiti.
Damn, that shit fucked me up, man.
Yeah. We out.
All right, we gone.